from News 8 WMTW-TV. This is a News 8 Now update.
You're watching News 8 Now. I'm Shannon Moss.
And I'm Erin O'Valley. The State Fire Marshal's Office is investigating a deadly fire at a home in Waterboro. Waterboro Fire Chief Matthew Boers tells News 8 that one person was killed in the fire at 29 Peasant Run Road. Firefighters were called to the home just before 9 o'clock last night. Chief Boers says when they arrived, firefighters attempted a rescue but were unsuccessful. Two other people were home at the time. One was able to escape through a small basement window. One was also taken to the hospital.
A 24-year Maine State Police veteran accused of sexually related crimes is due in Lincoln County Superior Court today for an arraignment. Gregory Vrooman is facing 4 counts of unlawful sexual touching, 4 counts of unlawful sexual contact with a minor. He is also charged with 4 counts of assault and 1 count of tampering with a witness. Vrooman was put on unpaid administrative leave after his arrest last November.
Maine's budget battle will continue in Augusta today, with rallies expected from groups for and against the governor's proposed changes to the state pension system. State employees, retirees, and others concerned about the plan held their first rally yesterday. All told, the changes would save about $400 million over the next 2 years, some of which would go to other budget items like tax cuts. The governor says it must be done, but some retirees say that these changes are just not fair.
When I retired, I did so with an understanding from the state of Maine as to what that would look like. Now the governor wants to change my situation and take back many of the benefits I thought I had earned and thought I could count on.
Let me say it again. If we do not act, people in this room will be forced to make funding decisions so dire that our current state retirement system will have to be cast aside.
Active and retired workers rally in the State House Hall of Flags. LePage supporters will hold their own rally outside between the Cross Building and the Capitol.
Well, if you live in Lewiston or Auburn, you now have the chance to vote on which new business you'd like to see open up in the Twin Cities. Yesterday, the Lewiston-Auburn Economic Growth Council introduced its 2 finalists in the Twin Cities Launch LA contest. Now, the winner will receive a total of $100,000 in startup money and in-kind services. The idea is to entice young entrepreneurs with roots in Lewiston and Auburn to invest in the community.
It just seemed like a no-brainer that it's the way to get back to the community. It's the way to start a business with low overhead based on all the prizes that are being given.
Home is home. How else do you put it? I grew up here. I know the place. I know the people. And it would just be fantastic to not only be my own boss, but be my own boss at home.
Don Havener currently lives in Massachusetts. He hopes to develop a manufacturing plant that builds safer and more innovative sports equipment. And Chelsea Fournier wants to open a member-based massage therapy center. Now, you can vote for the one you would like to see by going to the As Seen On section of our website. As always, that is WMTW.com.
And thanks for tuning in to this News 8 Now update. I'm Erin O'Valley.
And I'm Shannon Moss. Stay with us. We're going to bring the latest forecasts and sports highlights in just a few minutes. We'll be right back.